Lived a woodcutter and a daughter in a small village. The woodcutter went out every day carrying thorn bush branches and get them from the woods to provide for his daughter and himself. One day, his daughter asked for dead pigs.
Oh, dearest father, can we please have some dead pigs today? I'm sick of eating that slop. No offense, of course.
Yes, daughter, I suppose I can just go to the desert and just get more wood.
Thank you.
So the woodcutter went out to the desert to get more wood so he could pay off his daughter's dig cakes.
That's chopping wood.
He noticed it was getting dark, so when he got his pile of sticks ready, he came home. He knocked on his door. There was no answer, so he was forced to sleep on the porch that night.
Oh, I'll go get my back.
The next morning, he woke up. And once again, stretched out his back, he went out to collect more wood. He noticed it was getting dark, so he came home. He knocked on his door. But there was no answer. So again, he had to sleep on the porch. For the third time, he woke up. Went out to get more wood. And again, he noticed it was getting dark. He came home. Knocked on his door. There was no answer.
Dang it, every time! Lights!
Why are you so sorry, young lad? Only sir, for 3 days, I've gone to buy wood to get some day cakes for my sweet daughter, but every time I come home, I get locked out of the house and have to sleep on the porch.
Do you know what day it is, young lad?
Tis just a normal Friday Eve.
That's right. The Eve of Mushkilgusha.
Mushkilgusha?
That's right. The remover of difficulties. Just remember, every Friday Eve, share it to someone in need and tell the tale of Mushkilgusha. That way, you'll both be helped. Here are some raisins for you, so you can eat while you're on your porch.
Thank you, sir.
Where did he go?
Oh, Father, where have you been? And where'd you get those lovely raisins?
I know, babe. Okay, move around.
Days went by, and the woodcutter's daughter were walking in a public park, and she saw this fine princess of the kingdom.
Hello. Your Highness, how are you doing today?
I'm doing fine, thank you. You are a nice and hardworking young woman, especially beautiful. How would you like to be my handmaiden?
Oh my, I would love that. Totally.
So the woodcutter's daughter became a princess's handmaid. They became richer than their wildest dreams.
Here.
A month went by, and one day the princess went out to one of her father's gardens. There was a lake nearby, so she decided to go for a swim. She put her necklace on a branch, and she dove into the lake. When she got out, she forgot all about her necklace. So the next day, the princess was looking all over for her necklace and couldn't find it.
I'm sure we'll find it eventually. Things don't just disappear. How dare you betray me? You stole it.
Girl, what you talking about?
You're a lying thief and a cockhead and you mean as well.
I know you didn't.
Get her out of my sight.
Why am I such a loser?
Thank you.
woodcutter came out of the stocks. The princess was back in her fine kingdom, looking all over for a necklace. But when she went back to the garden, she saw something.
My necklace, so the woodcutter's daughter didn't take it at all.